Asian markets ended Thursday in a sea of red. The sell-off comes as Treasury yields stateside came in higher, its highest since 2007. Leading losses in the region was Hong Kong's Hang Seng, tumbling more than 2% in today's trade. Over in Japan, the Nikkei 225 slumped nearly 2%, despite Tokyo posting a higher than anticipated trade surplus in September. South Korea's KOSPI index was also down, even after its central bank kept interest rates steady. Here at home, Philippine shares joined the regional downswing, falling nearly 0.8%. Trading Edge's Ron Acoba says he doesn't see any near-term positive catalyst for the market.
Key resistance that the PSEI needs to hurdle is the 6,400 level. Unfortunately, I don't see any major catalyst that is enough for the PSEI to break past this level in the near term. As I've mentioned, it remains a wait and see whether the Fed is any closer to a policy pivot. It's not even the upcoming corporate earnings that will be delivered in the next couple of weeks that may act as a catalyst, even if they come in better than expected.
Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. arrives in Riyadh, Saudi Arabia to attend the first ASEAN Gulf Cooperation Council Summit. In his departure speech this morning, Marcos vowed to advance the country's interest in various fields such as trade and food security. He will also reaffirm the Philippines' advocacy for a rules-based international order to maintain peace, security, and stability in the region. While in Riyadh, the president will also meet with the Filipino community. Gulf nations are home to an estimated 2.2 million Filipinos working in critical fields.
It gives us, the Philippines, a unique opportunity to advance our priorities in ASEAN under the ASEAN GCC framework, while forging closer cooperation between the two dynamic regional organizations. This summit will serve as an important platform for the Philippines to highlight the need for cooperation in energy and food security, logistics, supply chains, digital information, the free flow of goods, people, and services, as well as the enhancement and protection of the rights, of course, of our overseas workers.
A U.S. agency pledges to invest $100 million for water services here in the Philippines. The United States Agency for International Development, or USAID, hopes the financial support can provide drinking access to 1.2 million Filipinos. USAID will also provide training and technological assistance to ensure select communities in the country have a steady supply of safe, potable water.
Here in the Philippines, we're seeing a situation of extremes. Too much or too little water. The United States has been a strong friend, partner, and ally of the Philippines in addressing these challenges head on.
Here are some local corporate headlines. BPI fires the opening salvo for third quarter earnings season, with its nine-month earnings jumping 33% to 38.6 billion pesos. The bank attributes its strong financial showing to sustained loan and margin growth, as well as tempered provisions. The Ayala-led bank's third quarter bottom line stands at 13.5 billion pesos, also its highest quarterly net income in the past decade. Meanwhile, San Miguel and Vista receive regulators' approval for their shelf offerings. Ramonang's conglomerate will offer 65 billion pesos worth of Series 2 preferred shares, whose proceeds will repay short-term loan facilities and invest in its Bulacan Airport project. Meanwhile, Manivillar's Vista Land will raise 35 billion pesos in fixed-rate bonds to refinance its maturing loan obligations. As for Cebu Pacific, it signs a five-year memorandum of understanding with Neste, the world's leading sustainable aviation fuel producer. The budget carrier aims to transition to all NEO fleet by 2028 and incorporate sustainable aviation fuel to its commercial network by 2030. And finally, the International Container Terminal Services breaks ground for its new project in Indonesia. The Razon-led firm's terminal will service East Java and is expected to be operational by September 2024. ITCSI previously secured $750 million in a loan from Metrobank to fund its overseas expansion.